nothing to risk. Sign up today.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi, folks. Basil Chapman, 5th day of June. My pleasure to be here. Tiger Technicians Hour, 877-927-6648. But I've got quite a bit to discuss first, so let's just get to the nitty-gritties. Just wanted to show you that after that report, the report at 8:30 with over 2 million extra here we're looking at here for this is the not, was that the non-farm payrolls? That's still a big number. But it's only 2 million. So what happens is you get a spike. And look, here's the 2-minute chart. The reason why I want to show you, because charts are charts, and we're going to have a look at this in the bigger picture coming up in a moment when I look at the monthly charts. But I wanted to show you, peak D is so important in the Chapman-Wave methodology. Yes, you can go higher, but D is where you lift your foot off the accelerator, hover over the brake, because you can have a small pullback, a big pullback. That's where other things can happen. Here it is, 2-minute chart goes to D, pulls back. Just a brief eight 2-minute bar pullback. Boom, peak ABC, D pulls back. Has a little rogue wave, spikes up with the technicals failing, goes to a slightly higher high, right here for a peak E at 10:16 in the morning Eastern Time, 31.84.25. Pulls back, creates a Chapman wave. I call this the oval pattern, stalk leg formation, breaks out to the upside. What does it do? Goes to a D, and then it just hovers. It holds the 9-period moving average, spirals up to a peak F, and then pulls back. And now that's where we are. But wait, that's the 2-minute chart. The 5-minute chart has made a peak F. Hey, wait a minute. The 10-minute chart has just made a peak E. This is where you should get the biggest pullback, but no, we're taking time rather than price. Now, I wanted to get it out of the way. It's got nothing to do with very near-term charts, 2-minute, 5-minute, 10-minute. It has to do with chart formation. So now let's go to the bigger picture. Here we go. I'm running all the numbers. I think the best would be for me just to run the numbers and discuss it in terms of each time frame. Daily, weekly, monthly, just kind of give you a picture, and anything that kind of pops up, I'll discuss a little later. I want to talk about this in greater detail. So here we are. We're going to look peak C, a little mild peak C right there in the Chapman wave inside track repellent zone, 200 period moving average. MACD is good. Stochastic is very good. Unbalanced volume pulls back, and you're at peak C, and I say, okay, you should go to a D. We're going to remain long. But if it goes to a D, probably for subscribers, this is where we'd normally get some kind of insurance. But I'm going to have a real tight stop because the percentage on that insurance shouldn't be outweighed by the long positions. So right there, we go short, holds for yesterday, and we go 1-1-to-1 short via the SH, which is 1-to-1 short the S&P. I don't want to interfere with our Dow positions. We're long, still long the option call from the day of the low at 23rd of March. And then at 2:10, we went long diamonds, still long. So I didn't want to mess with that because all my work says that this mega bull market, and if any of you listened to my interview with Jim Pavlova on Financial Sense about two Saturdays ago, was it one or two Saturdays ago? In that one, I discussed what would happen if we had to start to get to 26,000 now. And I discussed the fact that, and I've done this on the show many times, that I think that the major bull market of February of 2020 was aborted by a medical condition that had nothing to do with financial. You did not get the excessivity of the financials going crazy. You had no sector. Nobody was even talking about the stock market. I wonder what the story is now. Nobody, everywhere you went, people just refrained from talking about it. Even if they were in the market, I think they felt that if they did, it become a political weapon. They didn't even need it. They didn't want to discuss it. They were doing okay without talking about it. But there were no hot stocks or anything. Yesterday, I mentioned there were 15 on my list of screamers. These are single-digit stocks that had, looked like they had the potential to do a 3 to 6% gain. This morning, I wanted to add about two to my my list for my subscribers. They were all up already 3 to 12%. What can you do? I mean, and now there is not a single overbought on that list. So now let's go back to the market. What we're looking at here, this gap up in a leg D says, and we're up 940 points. Let's just say something happens by the end of the day, we're only up 320 points, right? Not 1,000, but something happens and we pull back. 320 points, we are still from the 25,600, 200 period moving average. We are still way above. What if we have three terrible days of selling that only gets us back to that level? So this is an extraordinary breakout. It raises the base of support. Doesn't mean to say that we aren't getting close to some kind of a pullback, but what it does is it says you've raised the base of support. Now, that look at the weekly chart. There's that propeller shaft I discussed. It has a Chapman wave formation. And I said, this really is too short. I like to have at least another three, four bars on the right to make that oval of the stalk leg formation. This looks more to me like a one-to-one expansion, where this is a fulcrum like a propeller shaft. Wow, look at this. Nice move up, 27,200. If we had to get a measured move, it could take us to just about 27,350 to 27,550, and that would be the next big resistance level, just based on the weekly chart. I'm not talking about any other technique. But look at that monthly. All right, let's go through each one. S&P, SPX.X, leg E, because it had that PD, but we were waiting for the ESM20, the E-mini, to make that leg D. What a leg D. Up 89 points, up 2.86% in one day, 3199.50. There's your leg D. Finally, you've got all the little ducks in order. Doesn't mean to say you get a sell signal. Just says, hey, this is huge. Okay, so that's the S&P, just to show you the daily. The daily is in leg E. The weekly is in leg C. And the monthly had a peak right there. Let me just expand this out a little bit. There you go. At 33.52 in February, that was a peak G. So any new high starts a brand new leg A in the monthly chart. So let's just see if there's a pullback, and maybe it'll be a B when it goes above 33.93.52 in 2 months' time. I don't know. All I can say is this is quite extraordinary. Talk about an aborted rally. Wow. Isn't this the proof? The V-shaped pattern? Talk about a V-shaped pattern. Here we go. QQQ up against it's not. See, it was leading. The XLK, the select tech, the semiconductor SMHs, SMH 154.10. I'm going to show you something quite extraordinary in a moment. Anyway, the Qs are bumping up against the resistance. Why? Because you've got stocks that the major leading stocks like an Amazon had a spectacular move up. It's just kind of consolidating here, just saying, you know what? Hey, everybody, you guys take your turn. I've had mine. Apple is at a new all-time high. I don't know if that's a new leg. I'm calling that a leg C. Maybe it's an E/C. It's amazing, right? And Netflix, NFLX, was coming off the bottom as I read it this morning. Yeah, it's trading at 414.76, up 43 cents, but it made its peak D. I think it's got a lowercase h, could make a dreaded H, but try to retest the 420s as a 414. It's only a peak C in the weekly chart, so that can still go higher. What have we got here? Amazon, Apple. What am I missing here? Oh, Facebook. Facebook is trading. Oh, yeah, it's just consolidating. That's why the Nasdaq is saying, hey, everybody, you take the lead. Let's see what our short-term charts are saying. Is that peak F? There we go, peak F pullback. There it is.
If you're not currently using the TAS profile scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS profile scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Hi, folks. The gold is in disfavor right now. It has broken the key level of support. It's now at 1684. It went down to 1671. Trading at 1684 right now. excuse me. That monthly chart is in a peak D, and it's saying from a D, you can anticipate some kind of a pullback. We'll see if it's going to be a little bit more serious. And this becomes a peak E in the weekly chart. All I can say is that breaking down, let's see where it closes, because if it closes under, not just under the 1688.8 low of the 21st of April, if it closes, it isn't just a close. If it closes below 1688, that's a negative. But if on Sunday night into Monday, gold is down more than 15 points, that would say, for now, gold is out the picture. It's had a spectacular run. It's out the picture for the moment. And silver, look, yes, silver. Silver's the same thing. It made a peak E right here the 5 days ago. And now I can put a down arrow because it's underneath the 14-period moving average. Magnesium just crossed negative and stochastic 71%. That's just the daily. The weekly chart is still really looking good, but it's back into the support. Remember, you got to be decisively above that Chapman-Wave falling series of trend lines at the top. You got to go nicely above it to make that support. Well, we went above it, but didn't close above it. We're now below it. So that makes a 16... I'd say 1685. In the 1680s, that's the next level of important support in silver. And any bounce should store at about the 70. It's at 1750. I'd say 1790 could be a resistance area. Now, this is going to be very important because the dollar is attempting to make some kind of a stance. But that weekly 200-period moving average, the orange line, 95.93. It looks like it wants to test it. So I can see a bounce, but I think the dollar's still in this whole corrective phase we've been talking about for some time. It's got a Chapman-Wave single leg A upside and the pullback in the weekly chart from 102.99. We're still long from 90. Did hit 100, almost 103. Now it's at 96. I'm still holding that for a long position. Subscribers know that we're looking at this as a potential foreteller in the next 6 to 12 months of the stock market holding well, and America once again becoming a prime economic force, and the dollar therefore would be representative of that. That's my thinking anyway. I want to show you something else. I had a question about the GDX. So the GDX made a peak G. I had changed that, but my system went down yesterday, so I lost a lot of notation. It's easy enough. I'll just get it back. So that isn't the data in a sell mode in the GDX trading at 31.48 down $1.63. I've got a peak C in the weekly chart, and that's suggesting that at some point, probably between 30 and 28, where the 200 period daily, 200 period moving averages, somewhere in here, very close in the next two, 3 days, or maybe a week, we could find some support. And how gold bounces is going to, the gold miners, how it bounces is going to be very, very important. The big question for me, and I think I've made it for subscribers as well, on the next big pullback, I said I'm going to become interested in gold under certain conditions. I'm not there yet, so I want to see how gold holds in the next 3-5 days. I want to see how the market acts, because if the market acts really well, I don't really see a rush to go back into something like a commodity, like a gold right now. So I'm just holding off, and I'm just saying, let's see if it does get to the 28s, how does that hold, and what does it tell at that point? If there's a big bounce, I still think gold is in a consolidation phase. Then I had a question. Let's see. I haven't got to it yet. Let's see what it says. Hi, Basil. Just subscribed to your newsletter, The Opening Call. Gone through 3 webinars. They're great. I was lucky. Got into X, that's U.S. Steel. Glad to see it's gone up about 20%. Not sure if you cover Forex trades, but if you do, maybe you can take a look at GBPCHF. GBPCHF. This is the, don't type it there, type it here. So I've got to say GBPCHF, and there we go. This is the British pound, Swiss, there we go. British pound. And this is the Swissie, I guess. So we've got Swiss franc and British pound combo. This is the pair in leg D. Now, let me just say, let me finish it up. And if you could look at CAD and CHF, all CHF pairs are showing same pattern. I caught the breakout last night. Hey, bravo. Appreciate it. Thanks, Kito. So, Kito, I'm going to do this. The GBP, CHF, British pound, Swiss, and the Swiss franc. This is the pair, and looking at it as a currency pair, is acting very well. The fact that it went to 1.225 and it's trading at 1.221 right now, in leg D, says if it's able to hold and have one more test close to the high of 1.2259. I suspect that it's going to try for the 1.2298 level, which is the 200-period exponential moving average. So this is exactly where you don't want to see it suddenly in leg D go to a peak D by Sunday night, Monday morning, and be pulling back to the 1.218 area, because that'll say, D's going to take time. If D can have a very quick, a one bar rest period, or very small, and extend, that's going to be really good. And if by leg E, if it does that, you can go to 1.23. That yen is telling you, the British pound yen currency pair is telling you that this wants to go even higher. This and leg D in the weekly, but a very quick ABC, and then it pulls back to a D, and just a nominal high, says that this is the area where you're bound to find the most resistance. And so that's what I'm saying. If it breaks above it, that's really important. I'll just do this for 1 second because it's kind of fun. It takes me off my usual ranting here. CHF, this is trading at 0.71668. And this is the Canadian dollar to the, I haven't seen this combo before, to the Swiss franc. And it did exactly what we're talking about. This one has touched the 200-period moving average of 7.18. It said 7.167. So I like this very much. And this is only leg C in the weekly chart. This is probably the stronger of the two that we're looking at. So this one has 0.715 to 0.7143-ish as support. If it has only 2 days going sideways and either makes a new high on Sunday night, on Monday, or just pulls back fractionally, and by Tuesday, it's already at 0.7205 or something like that. In other words, nominal high. That's going to be very good, and it turns this whole area of the 200 period moving average of 7186 into a magnet. So it can go above, it's probably going to retest, it can go below. Now that it's touched it, it's game. This is a tag game. Once you tag, you're okay. You can be tagged again. So I'm looking at that. Now let's do a couple of things here. The TLT, smash to the downside. Look at this, down 297, 154.25, down $1.89. Look at that arch formation that I drew some time ago. It's broken the support level. And look at the TBT. Actually, this is in leg E, down in the TLT. I'm calling this the leg C to the upside in the TBT at 1805, up 69 cents. This is really good. This is in range, but a breakout to the upside. Very strong move. I'll be right back. Got a ton of questions coming in. I'll be right back.
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman Wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that we'll even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
So I was also looking at Sabre. S-A-B-R is the symbol at 10.23. It's up $1.21, up 13.41%, gapped up. It's kind of a reddish candle. But the question is, what do I see? And this is to do with an option play. I'm going to just deal with what I'm looking at price-wise. And what I am looking at here, if you look at the left side, let me just drag this across. This is a daily chart on the left. If you look at the left side, and if I draw in a, let me get a pointer, there it is. And if I draw in from where it hit the high, you see this big red candle here? I suspect that the top of this candle, which is at 12.79, that's really quite a distance above 20%. That's the target line. And I love to talk about rectangles. I'll show you a technique that we use here at the Chapman Wave, one of the techniques that's been really successful in some of the charts that we formulated, because in dissecting them, the V-shaped pattern stopped dead, and it was not a V. And then it becomes a rectangle going to the most important left side high, and it could go to peak A, B, C, D, the fourth highest peak on the way up. And you have to check out where the strength is in the MACD, which is very strong, stochastic, not so much. So I suspect that that's the high in range for the next, I'd probably say the next 2 weeks. I know you might be looking at a little further. I'm looking at 2 weeks. So into the 1250, 1280 area, it's kind of the resistance. If it goes much higher, then all of a sudden that 200 period moving average of 14.70 becomes a target. But I don't think yet. I think this is a huge move. It's a breakout from the this is the Chapman Wave start and restart. Look, once it broke out above this whole area, it took so long. That's a powerful move. I used to have a way to draw in what happens to the left in time can happen to the right in price. I mean, that would take it up to 26, maybe even 28 over a period of a year. But I'm not going to do that right now. I'm just saying it reminded me of a technique that I used to use. I'm going to get back to it because we've had so many of these sideways moves with the breakout. I'm going to get back to thinking of that. Now, what's the downside? Well, the downside is this whole area where I've got the trend line at the 8.35, I would say between 8.45 and 7.80, over the next 2 weeks, that's probably the range. I think it's going to be, this is a major move, but I think that the big leg C in the weekly chart is saying to me, probably going to have to digest the gains once it starts to settle down. So that's what I'm looking at. I hope that helps you. And it can be modified because this is Neverland. We haven't been here before in anything. This is Sabre Core, and they do software for travel suppliers and buyers. All right. So now another question I had was, would I look at Boeing? Boeing, spectacular move. Remember, I was talking about this rectangle. It rains in a rectangle formation. I narrowed the rectangle, then I expanded it, and then I've got to go back to where it was yesterday when we were discussing it. And that was saying the high of 186.48. That's probably, when I was asked about it, was over there, and I said that's probably some kind of a target, but the 171 area had to be broken, which it was yesterday, and then it went right to the 186. It went to 188, actually. It broke above it, and now we've gapped up. This is almost, I think this almost, not quite, but it could have been the third gap-up session, but it's the second gap-up session. So I think that Boeing has turned the 175 area, the black 14 period exponential moving average, into at least intermediate term support. I'd say to 171, 175 to 171. And on the upside, I wouldn't be surprised if a chunk of the move has just been done. We have to go to the left side to see where it could go to next. And the way I do my work is I go to the next ugly candle. And here we are once again, just as I did on Sabre. The ugly candle of the 11th of March, 226, let's call it 227 high, 187 round number low. That's the area. So I'm thinking that right here into the 226 area, that's another 14 points higher. I think we're getting close to some kind of, at least a digestive phase for Boeing. This is a spectacular move, and this is without the court cases or anything. This is saying that we are hoping that Boeing gets its act together, because right now it's flying high, but its planes are not. So let's see what happens. Next question I had, Boeing, we did that. Oh, question about selling short Boeing. You know, at this particular point, I think you can see what happens if you're short and wrong, because the Fed is behind this. I mean, did we know yesterday that we would be up 900 points in the Dow, over 900 points, over 88 points higher in the S&P? We couldn't have known that. I could have guessed that we'd be up strongly if anything turned out to be slightly positive. Nothing like this. This is extraordinary. And that's the reason why, look, we got out of our Bank of America. It hit our stop. I just because we had a 6 point on a $19 stock, 6 point profit, I didn't want to give that back. And now look at it. It's back to 20, it's at 28.36. It just turned around and thumbed its nose and said, oh, you dodo, you should have been adding, not subtracting. We yields are going high. We didn't know it at the time. Yields are going higher. Look. Oh, look at this leg D. Now we've got a lot of gap up leg Ds. And that's just saying to me, I would not be surprised if next week we start to see some kind of consolidating. Now, to say bear market, no, I think now it's the challenge. And I'm going to talk about the V-shaped pattern in a moment, but this is the big challenge. Let me just check. Oh, Brent and Martinez. Brent, how are you?
Are you there, Bob?
Brent, I am so pleased I turned around and saw you there. Otherwise, I would be yakking away. How are you? I'm good.
Good. So you can hear me okay?
I certainly can. You would like to look at?
It's a company, Callon Petroleum. And so I had talked to you before about some of the smaller, you know, like Antero and Gulfport and Montage, some of the smaller oil companies that got, you know, of course, battered down, you know, like everything in March. But this one in particular was, I just wanted your thoughts on the pattern. It's going into that gap from back in March 9th, I guess, about 3 months ago.
And that's the ugly candle,
volume
right?
To surpass what it came down with. Just wonder your thoughts on it.
So we're looking at CPE. This is Callon Petro. It's trading at 1.34. It's up 0.51. It's like a pink sheet because it's got four digits. Go 1.35500. So I love the fact that it gapped up. And here it is trading at the higher end of the gap. That's different to what we were looking at a moment ago. And in fact, in a lot of stocks, what we're looking at is a lot of them gapped up into leg D, and actually they're pulling back from the high of the day. This is in C, and it's at the high of the, not the high, but close to the high. So the weekly chart, I've seen so many of these patterns. It's the rectangle pattern using time and not price. And then all of a sudden it starts to use price. I'm going to do this just as an experiment. And I've always meant to call TradeStation. I've got so many techniques that I could give TradeStation that all they'd have to do is get somebody to do the work, and it would be fantastic. Look what would happen. You see the weekly chart? I took it from the left side to the right, and I drew a straight line. Now I'm taking that line, and I'm raising it to the upside, and that'll give me the time and the price. I'll be back in a moment with Brent in California. We're looking at the Dow up 938, and CPE, we're looking at up 63%. Wow. I'll be back in a moment.
The gold market has taken off topside in a large way in 2020. If you want to take advantage of this sector, now is the time to subscribe to my gold report. The Gold Report took profits in four of its equities in the gold portfolio in the first week of January for a combined profit of 99.2%, with two positions left in the portfolio that have a profit of 67.5% as of January 7th. The Gold Report is a comprehensive look at the metals sector as well as the markets that move gold, which is the currency and bond markets. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, I publish the Gold Report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, as well as more than 30 different mining equities. To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the Gold Report, sign up now by visiting TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the next great gold trade. Sign up today.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look.
Trade CHAU or CHAD. Directions Daily CSI 300 China A-Share Bull and Bear ETFs. China A-Shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction Shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foresight Fund Services, LLC.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Hi, folks, we're back. Dow's up 947, and we're on with Brent in Martinez, California, and we're looking at CPE as a symbol. So, Brent, I did a little work on this. This is a technique that I was talking about just a moment ago, and we'll apply it to this. It says that the time that you take to go to the side without very much price movement, but successfully making higher highs and preferably higher lows, certainly you don't want to take out the low on the left side, which we haven't, which is at 0.38, I believe it is. 0.3800 back on the week of the 13th of March. If I draw a trend line, it takes you, as you can see in the daily chart, to exactly the high that we just hit today. So what I would normally do is I'd make that green, just change the color, take 2 seconds, green, then I snap parallel and it goes new parallel. I make that red and it says, aha, we've just gone into the Chapman Wave inside track repellent zone, which means that if you break out above it, the green line becomes support, and that's great. But I said to myself, now let's use your usual technique. So my usual technique is to go to the left side and take a trough of importance and draw a trend line through the most important high that was made, and that's this high that was made on the 30th of April at 1.09. That takes me to a level of, it depends when, but somewhere in the 1.68 area. Well, now I can go to the weekly chart and show you that the pattern that I had before of time becoming a vertical target price, not necessarily time-wise, but the price itself, takes you to about 2. Since I'm not able to grab that point on the right and just grab the left and swing it over, I have to imagine that I've correctly anticipated the trend line, and that takes me to about 2.10 to 2.21. So that's my upside target, and it'll be underneath the high of the ugly candle of the week of the 6th of March, which has a high of 2.35. So I'm suspecting that if there is any pullback after today, if it's just brief, and there's like an inside bar, let's say Monday doesn't make a new high, it has an inside, or if there's a new bar, I wouldn't be surprised if we get like two. We don't get the sideways move with the gap. This time we get maybe a 2-bar, maybe even a 3-bar pullback. And then there's a sudden up spike, and I suspect at about 150, it just stalls in the 150s. And that takes you to the next level of just waiting, having patience for the next big move up. But you can see There's a beautiful uptrend line in the chart from the dating low that was made mid-April to the May low, and that just gives you tremendous support right here at about on a worst case basis of 0.75. I don't think we're going to do that until we at least attempt a peak C. The other thing you can say to me, but wait a minute, look how long it took in the cup formation. And perfect. Look at this. If Larry was looking at this, I'm sure he'd call this like a 135 breakout with a rising trend line. But I love this cup formation. Remember, I like to count the number of bars, and I suspect the number of bars from the high of the 26th of March at 0.79 makes a cup formation and goes to the high of the 30th at 1.09. And now we've done almost the sound. I don't want to take time to measure it now. It's very close to the gap today. You could say, wait a minute, we could have a long cup. I think we're now in the acceleration phase based on the weekly technicals. So I don't think we're going to rest for more than a few days, and then it's going to try for the 150s. I hope that helps you, but that I congratulations. You've been picking these things up fantastically. Really beautiful technique.
Yeah, this one, when I bought it, Basil, I plan on hanging on to it for, I don't even know how long. I have 20,000 shares of it, so I'm going to go ahead, and I think my average is about 45 cents. So I really want to, this one probably more than any of them. It's a company that should not be trading where it's at. So we'll see over time. It'll you know, it's starting to finally make a move. And it was a little frustrating because it was, of course, just kind of going sideways for a long time when some of the others had made a move. But it's you know, taking
this one
right now.
That's another thing that the delay with this buying right now, the way I'm looking at it, I think there are new buyers coming in right now. And that should give you the support in the 1.20 to the 1.18 level on a very short-term basis. Hey, very nice. Thank you very much for calling. And I'm sure a lot of people are going to be looking at this as well. CPE, and that's called Callon Petrum.
Yep.
thank you very much for showing it to us, Brent.
All right.
Have a good weekend. Thank you. So, folks, this is, I want you to, in the interim period, we had a number of questions that came up. Could I talk about my cash index? So cash is Cintas, and as I said to subscribers, it's had a spectacular move. I should have just jumped on 3 days ago and saying, you know what? Cintas is telling me that there is a recovery going on in the overalls, uniforms, rentals. That is extraordinary, and that is really important. I'm not even looking at this as a stock to own. I'm looking at it as a stock that's telling us about the economy. And then look at that V-shaped pattern. I never expected that it would come back so soon, because I thought that the most people that were out of work were the very people that would be using overalls and uniforms. Look how many hotels, you know, shut down, etc. This is, I love to see this. I don't love the fact that we didn't get in when I said we would get in, but it's there. Cash is C-A-S-H. So Amazon is for the A. Amazon, we saw, it's kind of stalled a little bit here. It's up today, 13. High-level consolidation should still make leg D above the high that was made at 25.42 back in the 21st of May. And S is for SPY. So we were short the SPY. We took a 2% loss, and we were very lucky because over the couple of days that we had it, the Dow was way stronger. So the holding the Dow was actually far more beneficial, knowing that we just had a little bit of insurance, and that was good. So now you're in leg E in the SPY. So it's getting a little stretched in letter names, but that doesn't need to say it's stretched in price, because this thing is formidable. I mean, can you imagine being short and not being able to cover, or just being adamant that you're right, and the market saying, no, excuse me, will you look at your portfolio, because I'm up 8.70, I'm up 2.8%, the SPY index, and that is, and Home Depot. So cash, C-A-S, H is for Home Depot. Home Depot is up a little bit, up 5 at 253. This is a brand new A, B, C, D, E, F. Oh, this could be an F, but I think I'm going to be more conservative. A, B, C, D. I'm calling this a D. I won't do the notation now. I'm just telling you that I think it's in a D on the way up. And a new all-time high. Home Depot, building materials, appliances, home, electric, whatever you want. Home Depot is at an all-time high. A spectacular move. Well, okay, so that's the cash index. The other thing I was asked about is, let me just check here, where was it? Wrong mouse, wrong computer. Slide over, let me get this. Fed injection. As they say, never fight the Fed. Pretty amazing. With the market valuations at the highest level since 2000. Kevin, you know, Kevin, everything has been so distorted that I think you have to just consider that if the Fed is there as your backup means, wow, you have to just consider that they have the wherewithal to do it. Whatever they want. And so far, it's really been working. I'll be right back in a moment. We'll do the wrap-up for the week in a moment. Look, that PKF held the reduced time more than price. I'll be back.
Back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006. And like many of you, was drawn in by...
Bam!
As well as...
Whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us. And Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab.
Bam!
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated fulvic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks, this is Steve Rhodes. Stay tuned for another great hour of the Trader's Edge, heard here at TFNN.com.
Oh, yes. Remember the PKF and the two-minute chart I was talking about? And remember the PKF and the 5 minutes and the PE in the 10-minute chart? Look what we've done. We've gone from a 3,210.50 E-mini S&P June, that is, the high, and we're at 31.97. I mean, 31.97. It's a pullback. And any other time, that would have been deep. Right now, you can see barely made a note. It's more time than price. Okay, this is what I'm talking about. Looking out, what's happening now is going to be, I'm hoping that there is a pullback starting next week. And I hope it's a pullback with some price and some time involved. I don't want a two-day, three-day pullback. I'd like to see a pullback. I don't want to see 15 mid-cap 2000 screamers. Now it's went to one from 15 to zero, and now it's four. And I do like to see the same names keep coming back because it means that's consistent. But this is saying to me that there are people out there that are starting to trade like they used to trade back in the 1999 period, and a little bit like 2007, although it was mostly housing. This says to me that I want to pull back here to get things leveled out. I don't want to make some kind of a top here over the next few weeks that really takes us down in time and price and very seriously. So this is the cusp. We're on the cusp. Because if we have another week like this, you will not have anybody out there that isn't going to, in fact, want to stay at home and do trading. So that's going to be a big difference. I would prefer to have this. I just want breathing, natural breathing, like you're running a marathon, not like a sprint. So anyway, that's just my opinion, but I'm not complaining. And so this is good for our stocks. But it's now we've got time. Is compressed, you've got speed, you have to jump on and get in and take your profits. It's a little different. So that's all I'm saying. You've got Steve coming up, you've got Dave coming, you've got Tom O'Brien. Check out my opening call, my daily newsletter. See it on the front page of TFNN. This weekend, I'm going to try to give a little bit of different picture, and I'm going to add a couple of screamers for any potential for next week. I want to play a little bit of the game here. I don't want to overdo the spending. I want to see if we can conserve some cash.